Hi guys, I'm Joel. Thank you for watching this video. So the latest event, the Outskirts of Town event, has begun. I'm going to talk about the cards and give my thoughts on the cards and what cards I think are good to get. But first off, let's just talk briefly about the event. So the event is pretty standard. I would even consider it lackluster in terms of the map, because you get this thingy like one way. And then obviously you unlock Area 5, and eventually when you get one copy of Mortar and one copy of Nona, the SR cards, and then you get the standard point fair. And then the point fair is just standard, nothing special. This SR card could be useful, but you need two copies of her, and I don't know how you get the second copy. But and so let's go to the thing I want to talk about, which are the cards, the main thing I want to talk about. And then you can see that in this event, there's the UR card, Regea. I don't know how to pronounce her name, but I'll just call her Regea. And Regea can be can be gotten by combining Morta and Nona, the HSL versions of them. And you get these three older cards, which is Dark Alice, Bertina, and Alice. For example, Dark Alice has 250% damage to all enemies. I guess she's the most useful out of the three, but she's not unique by any stretch. But she's a good card for alliance battles or as defense. And then Bertina is, I guess if you don't have any UR cards, then she could be your attacker card, because her skill is own attack up by 300%, which is a pretty standard thing. So, but then for people who have UR like me, then she's pretty much a medal fodder, I would call. And then you have Alice, and Alice at first I thought she's a really good card, but then I realized she isn't, because she's a turn stopper, and she stops people's turns for 4 turns, and I thought it's really good. But then I realized that she only activates when battle starts, like with a 10% chance or a 30% chance once you max out a skill and awaken her. And then so they're okay to have, but I wouldn't really consider them cards to be worth grinding for or using your items for. And then so let's talk about the main cards, which is Regea, like I talked about. And then she's very good because she has two skills, and she's a UR. Both skills are useful. All attack is useful in many situations, for example in alliance battles as a defender card. And then she can be used as a turn stopper as well, which is a crucial element of my strategy. You can check out my elemental hall video to see what my strategy is. Basically it involves having 4 turn stoppers and one proper attacker. And then you can see here you can combine them. And it's really easy to get her, because, for example, I got Morta already. Okay, I'll just talk about this thing first. For example, I've only beat Morta 32 times, but I have already gotten her already. And my estimation for getting the cards is actually, according to my data, if you have been following my video, my channel, you would see that I've been doing statistical analysis on the drop rates of the units, and you can see here I got Morta already, right? Morta. Why didn't she activate? Okay. See? One Morta. And I've only beaten her 32 times, as I just showed you. And then back to here, you can see where how you get Morta and Nona. Basically, just keep beating her, and then eventually you'll get her, or you can max out like ability. Both works. And so this is what I want to talk about. So in the last event, I actually kept my Lolita Alchemist, because her skills are so much better than the UR, and I didn't change her into the UR. And then so, but in this event, I prefer the UR more than the SR. For example, Morta, the skill, basically, in this game, this type of skill is not good, because you're not able to one-shot first off, you're aiming to kill the Fantasy Archwitch, and you can't one-shot her, because there's the damage cap of 1 million minus 1 damage. And even if you manage to buff her very high, and she activates, you can't really beat the Fanny's Outreach in one battle point, which is what you want to aim for. And then skill nullification for Nona isn't especially good either. I mean, there are some people who swear by this skill nullification skill. You can see, for example, in Alliance Battle, some people put 3 to 2 skill nullifiers into their defense deck. I guess it sort of works, but I myself prefer to go on the offensive and have 4 attack cards, like all attack cards, and then 1 turn stopper. But that's for another video. But anyway, that's why I don't think these 2 SRs are worth having. Worth keeping, especially when you can combine them for this very, very good UR. And then finally, I'm going to talk about the ranking reward, which is Decima. Decima is a very good card for Alliance battles or for defense, but ranking is extremely hard in this game. You have to use items. As for all TCGs, basically, the more items you accumulate, the better the chance you have. So if someone asked me, or actually I've been asking myself, is Decima worth using your stash on? I don't think so. I'd rather save it for another card that has, for example, better art and better skills. For example, a attacker skill, I would consider a better skill to actually use your stash of items. For example, the swords and the shoes, right? On. And the final one is in the Elemental Hall, the final card I want to talk about. Her name is... Nope. This one. Yeah. Her art's pretty good. I like her art. But as a card, then she's... The issue is you need 5 copies of her to turn into HSR. And it's going to be quite a pain, basically. And she's good for Alliance battles, defense, or even campaign, but you know. Once you reach a certain point, you don't really need a special campaign deck. I don't think she's worth spending too much time on or spending items on, because Elemental Hall is very hard to win. It takes lots of battle points, is what I mean. So anyway, this is my quick review of the latest event, the Outskirt of Town, I think it's called. And so if you like this video, leave me a like. If you have any comments, for example, what you think of the latest event, leave it in my comment section below. And if you like Valkyrie Crusade videos, subscribe to my channel, because I'll be making a lot more of these videos as I continue playing this wonderful game. So thank you for watching, and you guys have a great day, and good luck in getting cards you like in this event.